Hello everyone, I am Bipasha Kalita and I have been very fortunate this time to attain All India Rank 41 in the CSE 2017 examinations. If I can give a small background where I come from, I am from a small state in the northeast called Assam. I am from Guwahati and this was my fourth attempt. In the previous attempts I failed. In the first attempt I wrote mains, I couldn't clear mains. In the second and the third I could not clear prelims, and this was my fourth attempt where I have been fortunate to have cleared all the three hurdles and to have secured this high rank. If I can give a brief background, my father was a civil servant. My younger sister is in the IPS in 2016 batch, and I am currently working in the Assam Civil Services. I work for the state services, and so that's a brief about the background. As I already mentioned, I come from Northeast, so if I can speak a little on that issue. In Northeast, the awareness about civil services is relatively lesser than the rest of the country. But now there has been a positive trend where more and more people are coming out and they are appearing for the civil services. In fact, this time from the state of Assam there has been 17 successful candidates, which is a very good number if we see the last year's trends. And in Northeast I think rank 41 is the top rank, and I think in the history of Assam I am the first married woman to have made it, and the first married Assamese women to have made it to top 50. So I would like to take this opportunity to motivate all the girls and women out there, especially women who are married, to not give up your aspirations and keep pursuing your dream. And when you get married, there's a lot of familial responsibilities that gets attached to you, but if I can do it, then everybody can do it. Secondly, if we see the results every year, the ratio is very skewed. There's a lot of boys and men who make it to the list, and the number of women who make it is not as at par with that of men. So I would like to tell all the girls out there, all the women out there, to try for civil services, because this is a platform which gives you immense opportunity to work for the society. It is an amazing platform. If I can speak a little bit about my struggle, what were my key points and why I failed in my previous three attempts and why I feel I have made it to top 50 this time. My biggest hurdle was clearing the preliminary exam, the first round. And I think clearing the preliminary round is the toughest, because if you see the ratio, the number of people who take the preliminary exam and the number of people who are selected, around, if I'm not wrong, around 12,000 people are selected in the first round. So that was where my struggle was. I could not clear prelims in the last two attempts, and that was a huge demotivation for me, because where was I going wrong? Somewhere I was going wrong, and that was my challenge, to figure out where I was making that small mistake, that I'm not clearing the first hurdle, leave apart the second and the third hurdle, the mains and the interview. So I sat down for this attempt, I sat down and I decided that my first task will be to make an analysis of the questions which have been asked in the past 20 years in the preliminary stage. Because I figured there has to be a pattern, because in UPSC nothing is without a pattern, there is a pattern. And so I sat down, I took out the last 20 years preliminary question papers, and actually I made an Excel sheet and I figured out from which book, from which chapter they are asking questions. And that is where I found out that there's a pattern from where they are picking up the questions, because in UPSC nothing is discretionary, there is always a purpose. So that analysis of the last 20 years question papers helped me a lot, and that's where I realized that probably I was not focusing on certain parts which are important, and my focus was hovering around somewhere else. That was the first thing that I did, and I think that was a very fruitful task that I had taken. Secondly, I wrote a lot of tests. I will not speak about the book list. I will not speak about the source, because I think all of us, we very well know that we have to read the NCRTs, we have to read the newspapers, what the core book list is, everybody knows. So I would not go into that domain. But I would like to focus here that in prelims, the key point to clear the exam is to reduce your incorrect answers and increase your correct answers. Because if you are opting for 80 questions and 50 questions are right and 30 questions are wrong, you are losing the battle. So that's where I focused on, that in the previous two attempts, my incorrect questions were very high, but correct questions were very less. So another strategy I had to adopt. So what strategy I adopted? I solved a lot of tests. Apart from being very thorough with the basic books, with the NCRTs and the book list, I solved a lot of tests. If I can speak now, just 90 days, I counted the days, 90 days to prelims, I started solving 100 questions every day. So I took a pledge that I will not go to bed without solving 100 questions every day. So I would pick up, there are lots of tests in the market, and in online platform you can find out a lot of tests. So I did, so these 3 months, from 3 months before prelims, I started doing 100 questions, one paper every night before going to bed. And trust me, that helped me so much. My accuracy was so high in prelims that this time, every question, I did not even have to think twice. My accuracy had gone so high, and I did around 82 questions in this time, in last prelims. Out of that, my correct questions were 79 and incorrect were just 2 or 3. So you can see that I had reduced the number of incorrect to just 3 questions. So that is where the practicing the tests every day helped me a lot, and it made a lot of difference. And apart from that, for prelims, I would say newspaper reading. I read the Hindu daily. That is of big help. And online also, there's a lot of material online, but we have to be judicious when we select our source, because the internet is a big, vast area, and it's like the ocean. But from the ocean, how do you pick up the most relevant source and the most valuable source that will add value to your preparation? That is the challenge. So you have to be very careful there. I follow 2 or 3 sources, not more than that, because eventually, along with hard work, you also have to do smart work. And smart work will come there where you don't get lost in the process, and you don't read too much, but you keep your sources for every topic to 2 or 3 sources, and you constantly revise that. That has been helpful for me, and I think it will be helpful for others as well. And apart from that, one important thing which I would like to focus is, how do you constantly keep yourself motivated? Because civil services is a journey where if you fail in any of the rounds, you come to zero. So it's either 0 or 1. There is nothing in between. When I used to fail in my previous attempts, I had to sit for another 12 months to sit for the next round. So that was a challenge which I faced, that how do you constantly keep yourself motivated? How do you constantly stay focused? How do you constantly maintain your consistency and not lose hope? So this is where you have to inculcate the never give up attitude, because you have to keep at it and you have to keep trying, and eventually hard work pays off. So how did I keep myself motivated? In a month, I used to go out for a movie maybe, and I used to go out, my husband would come down and we would go out for lunch or dinner, but that would be just once in a month, which is like a good break. But but what I learned in the process is that we shouldn't overburden ourselves with a lot of pressure, because many students do that, many aspirants do that. They feel that agar ye nahi hoga to life khatam ho jati hai. That is not the idea. Life doesn't stop here. The civil services examination is not the end of the world. Because itna prepare karne ke baad, you are anyways coming out a very aware and a very knowledgeable person. So you will do better in any field that you choose. So you need to understand that this is a process which you need to enjoy, because without enjoying the process, you will get very pressurized and you will always be under a lot of stress. So that is where you have to constantly tell yourself that I need to enjoy the process. I need to do this with a very happy state of mind, and stop yourself from getting frustrated. Lastly, if I can talk about what, just quickly, now I think there's just 24 to 25 days to prelims. So if I can say something about what these last few days, what the candidates can do, what you all can do for prelims. I think these last few days, it's very crucial that you revise what you've already studied, because revision is the key. If you have missed out on one source, it's absolutely okay. Just revise what you have already done. There's no point picking up something new. Also, if possible, solve one test paper every day. If you have not started that now, till now, start that, because 24 days, 100 questions, that would be around how many? 2400 questions, and that will give you a lot of confidence. Trust me, I can speak from my own experience. And apart from that, for mains, what helped me was newspapers are very important for mains. For mains, I read two newspapers, The Hindu and The Indian Express. That also helped me in writing good essays, actually. It helped me in answer writing. And apart from that, I had joined just one mains test series, but I did not have the time to write too many tests. I wrote just three or four tests. And for essay also, I just wrote one or two tests. But a writing practice is one which you have to constantly build up. It will not build up after prelims, you know. You have to constantly keep writing, and you need to see that, you know, you are meeting the demand of the question. So I had started the answer writing process a year before. So I must have written quite a few answers. There are many portals online which gives you the opportunity to write answers. So I used to write answers on my own. And I think that has been helpful. And apart from that, I would like to wish luck to all of you, and never lose hope. You might fail in one attempt, you might fail in the second, you might fail in the third, you might fail in the fourth, but if you are consistent and if you believe in yourself, I think no one can stop you. Thank you so much.